It's a theory haunting those already on the Alzheimer's journey that the path of this dark disease may cross that of COVID-19.
They're interested in how being infected with COVID-19 relates to subsequent cognitive decline.
Dr. Michael Rosenblum with the Health Partners Center for Memory and Aging says a new international study following 40,000 COVID patients from nearly 40 countries will respond to some of the cognitive signs they're already seeing by getting to the bottom of COVID's long-term toll on the brain.
We know that this is a virus that does have a predilection for the central nervous system.
The theory that just as scientists saw a surge in issues from memory problems to anxiety to psychosis following other respiratory viruses like the flu of 1918 or SARS, so does it appear COVID could leave its lasting mark by attacking the very area of the brain responsible for both the sense of smell and short-term memory. Doctors believe the virus could also hurt the brain by creating blood clots that cause strokes, triggering an immune response that backfires on the brain, or simply by cutting off oxygen.
So if a patient has respiratory failure and the brain is deprived of oxygen, this can further impact cognition.
And while Rosenblum braces for what could come from COVID,
this potentially could present a crisis.
He's joined by familiar allies.
How devastating could this be to our greater community?
If there is a link and more people are diagnosed because they had COVID disease, it would be astronomical, the cost.
Sue Spalding with the Alzheimer's Association acknowledges the potentially devastating intersection of two crises, especially given the global reach of COVID-19. But today, she and others also look to this study, and the worldwide research advocates hope will shed light on what's ahead.
Again, we need to really understand how this is impacting us so we can figure out better treatments, better courses of care, what kind of support and services, additional needs that people might have in the long term.
Both the Alzheimer's Association and the World Health Organization support this study, which will go on for 2 to 3 years. They hope to have initial results by early 2022. If you'd like to learn more about this study or other Alzheimer's research, just go to our website, care11.com. Back to you.